Good morning all. Firstly, I will welcome all the participants and the singer sir for being here with us. Today we are having a webinar on harnessing the benefits after the lockdown. So I will just introduce a brief introduction has been given by the sir. He has done MBA in marketing and information system from Devi Ahilya Vishwavidyalaya Indore. And he has been working in the industry and academics from the last 18 years. And he has a taste to talk with the students in the academic world. He is taking the guest lectures at many of the universities at Bareilly and Lucknow. He was previously working as a marketing head of Pizza Hut, North India. And presently he is working as a franchisee head for UP and with Western Union Money Transfer. So today we requested him to be with us because as all the engineering and the marketing people, they all are related with the market. And now after this lockdown, a long lockdown period, industry is changing. Consumer trends are changing and we all are talking vocal for local. So how the students can take the benefit of this situation? So for that, we requested sir to be with us, and he very readily agreed, and he gave us a time from his very busy schedule, though it is very difficult for him because as the tough time is going on in the industry also, so he has to look a very big family as a head of Uttaranchal and Uttar Pradesh franchise here, so he has to take care of all the business and the people. So without wasting any time, I just welcome sir and will like to hand over the proceeding to him. Welcome, sir. Sir.
Thank you, Abhijit ji. Very nice. Thank you. And I would like to thank Professor A.M. Khan ji and Professor Abhijit ji. They helped me into actually interacting with all of you. And before we start on this, I just want to ask a few, can we ask questions from the students, sir?
Yes, sir. Definitely, you can ask. They will be available in the chat box because we have not opened the audio to all. And we have the audience from South and other places also. So they are requesting in the chat box to talk in English. Previously, we both were conversing in Hindi as it was not the official opening at that time.
Okay. I just wanted to ask on this only. So those of you who have joined here,
yes, sir,
wanted to know that from the students, they just want to know that you can raise your hands wherever you want to ask some questions or want to. You can send a question on your chat box and raise your hand so that we can. I can take up the questions then. And so lockdown is the feature which I think I am seeing for the first time. Probably you are also seeing for the first time. There is nothing, and this is for the first time in the world which has happened that the whole world has come to a grinding halt without there being fought up. There is not a war, and this is not a natural calamity. So anytime such kind of situations crop up, what could be the best solutions which everyone in everyone's mind is coming, that what are the best solutions? What are the best proceedings? How to get the best out of this situation? And if I am a student or I'm in the final year of some place, I would like to know what will actually happen to my career. To question a lot of these, I have prepared a small PowerPoint for you all. They are interactive to certain extent, but if you would like, you can ask your questions. And questions are- This is the situation which I was first shared recently one of my colleagues on WhatsApp. We are on a blade. We can't move forward. We can't move backward. And we can't stay on this blade also for a very long time. This is the reason why government actually utilized the tool of lockdown. Thereafter, for around 40-50 days, the lockdown was got into the process of unlocking. And now you can see, though the virus scare is increasing at this moment, but yet unlock process is going on. Because the last saying which is written here, can't stay like this for long. So life is important. Business is not that important, but to support life, we require some business. Business actually gives us two things. One is it helps us to understand the importance of getting up daily in the morning. Why should we get up daily in the morning when we don't require to get up daily in the morning? So that is the proceedings of business. If you don't have the business, then you will never get up daily in the morning. The second thing comes as, if we don't have money, we can't transact. We can't buy things which we require, because demand, as goes in the book of Philip Kotler, and many of you who may have understanding of marketing and economics, even engineering students get taught by the subject of industrial management, I think, and industrial psychology, I think they are being taught. Economics is also taught, I think. So these terms are quite common. Demand is the ability to buy. It is not the interest of buying. If I have a demand, I would like to have a mobile phone of certain brand, and I don't have the right amount of money in my pockets, then the demand is a pseudo demand. That means I will never be able to buy it. I can wait for discounts. Like you must have just seen a few days ago, Flipkart sale was going on. I was also trying to buy a few things. Those things which I wanted to buy were not available. Those things which I just thought of buying were kept in my cart. And it went on for, I think, 3-4 days. And they were kept in the cart for 3-4 days, and they are still there. I hadn't bought it. Because I yet think, what I will do with this thing, what I will do with that thing, can I avoid them? And I am trying to avoid them. Such kind of scenario is called consumer confidence. Consumer confidence is growing low. They are not interested in buying things nor keeping them for very long term with them. If it is very important, they will buy. Like FMCG things, like you must be knowing about, in Hindi we use the term gehu chawal, and in English it is rice and wheat. Anywhere, whatever happens on this earth, rice and wheat will never be a difficulty. You have to buy it. You may buy a lot of gold at this period of time. Gold is rising. You can buy gold. But if you don't have rice and wheat back home, you will buy rice and wheat first, and then you will buy gold if you have extra money. So many of you might have heard of one great scientist called Maslow. He has developed a motivational triangle in which the lowest one is called physiological needs, which in Hindi we call, it's very popular, roti, kapda aur makan. Roti is food, hunger. Kapda you can call as anything which protects us, because we don't have fur like animals, or protection we don't have, natural protection we don't have. And the makan is basically called the shelter. Shelter is something which is just saving you from rain, from extreme heat, from hailstorms, anything like that. And when you go a bit above, it's called social security, which comes into that security. That requires the same roti, that same hunger gets converted into a pizza, can be converted into a bun, bread, or same wheat, what I'm talking about. And in the category of clothing, that because of security purpose, we will have cloth which can actually cover us, and even like a jacket. In the first category, the lowest one, when we are using the cloth part of it, it is just we can cover ourselves. It is not protecting us properly. Like if anyone has seen a movie called Rambo, Rambo in the first movie was called First Blood. In that, what happened, that person was actually taken up as a prisoner, and he has to run away from the prison. So, since he was not wearing any clothes, what he did was he tore up a canvas from a big truck, which was like you might have seen a CRPF vehicle or a police vehicle. They have got canvas covering at the back of the truck. He tore that thing, put a small big hole on its top so that the head goes in, and he just wore it like a sack. His head was in, and the remaining part he was on his shoulders. Just that's it. That was not a cloth. It can't protect you, because on the sides water can enter, cold air can enter. The sides are open, only your head is covered and your shoulders are covered. Your torso is covered basically. So in the category, when we are drawing this Maslow's cycle, the security part of it goes for the cloth is that it will have buttons, it will have a zip, it will be fully enclosed. If in any point of time, it will protect you from cold or heat anywhere. And when it comes to the shelter part of it, when it goes in the second category, that is the security part, that shelter becomes a house which has got a window, which has got a door, where you cannot enter that particular area until and unless you have taken the permission of the owner. This part is actually getting, we are getting the actual pressure in this part in our lives these days. Maslow's triangle is basically called motivational, it's called hierarchy of needs. Hierarchy of needs. It's a motivational triangle to make people understand. And the second part we are getting into, the security part, is actually pinching us today. Then the third part in that triangle is the love needs, which we call the social needs. And thereafter, when we go on the other, esteem needs, and the top one is self-actualization. So students are basically in the second need part. Till you are, you become a businessman, or you become a executive in one of your companies, your favored company, you are in the social, you are into that security need part. And that is actually pinching most of us. Even I am at present circulating between social and security part. So anytime this comes into our mind, we started, our motivation starts to get down. So nothing to worry much. We can talk over it. We can think over it. And this is the right time to study. This is the right time to think. This is the right time to use all the tools you have actually learned in your throughout your lifetime. So till date, whatever your tools you have learned, you should be able to use these tools. So in that beginning, just went like I will be forwarding on this. According to the magazine, the Harvard educated Devita Saraf is one of the wealthiest women entrepreneurs under 40 in India. Anyone maybe knowing about this company called She's the CEO of View Televisions. It's a very popular television today. And her father was Rajkumar Saraf, is Rajkumar Saraf, who owned Zenith Computers. So just wanted to know that this is a new kind of entrepreneurs who have entered into India. And she is the wealthiest woman entrepreneur, not because of her ability to produce a television. Television is not the important thing. The important thing is the idea. She is able to produce good ideas. Once she is able to produce these ideas, and this is the reason she is able to sell this television. 1,000 crore is a big thing in television industry today. As there are ample number of televisions available, two big brands most of you must be knowing. One is the Sony, the other one is Samsung. They are very popular, and and LG is also there. But these two brands are much bigger than LG at present in television market. Then they have got MI has also entered into this market with their smart TV, and smart TVs are getting cheaper day by day. 32 inch is the call of the day. Anything under 32 doesn't usually people don't prefer. And day by day, the price of TVs are going down under. The market is available at around 11,000 somewhere. In Vue, it is available in 11,000 somewhere. In other brands, it is like MI 30,000. And other brands, Sony, Samsung, they are around 15,000-16,000 onwards. So in such kind of a very difficult scenario where you don't have a brand name, where you don't have a great goodwill, Vue Televisions California is the only brand name you know. Why a person will start buying a product? Why a person will buy? Only because you are cheap. Cheap can sell for a particular period of time. But Redmi has actually shown the way that if you sell a product through e-retailers, your cost of maintaining and maintaining franchisees, maintaining profits are much lowered and controlled by having a entry and exit through this e-portals. E-markets are much better and easier to access than having physical markets here and there. So Redmi is the one of the biggest brands and most, I think, success stories in India who have been able to establish themselves through this mechanism only. She has done the same thing for Vue Televisions. Vue Televisions in stores, you will find them. They are available of around last year onwards. They have actually started putting up into brick and mortar stores also. But mostly they are available online. And this particular brand has been able to create a niche market for itself. And the best part of it is that in e-retail stores, what happens? You buy a product, immediately you will find people, someone is giving some chat. Just a second. Anta Kakati has written, please throw some light on Indian entrepreneurs. I am going through them. Anything extra? This is one of the entrepreneurs. She is an Indian one and research scholar. She is a research scholar. Anything more? Remaining chats are, I think, good morning ones. So we can ignore. So this is the first known example at present. Like a small known thing was recently shared by Xiaomi. It said that Redmi, like people were telling that we are not having a proper level of markets and we are not able to sell anything. But because of made in China effects and boycotting of made in China. So Xiaomi has just reported the Redmi 9 Pro mobile sold in just 52 seconds are a decent sale. This is they can speak like this, but it doesn't mean that they have provided ample number of Redmi phones. 52 seconds, if they have been sold off, that doesn't mean that it has been able to cater to the total demand of the people available. Supposedly 1 lakh people wanted to buy and you put 1,000 only in between them. Then 52 seconds are more than that is not the right way of making people understand that this is our markets are not shrinking. But yes, this products like mobiles, laptops, headphones, speaking objects, tabs, as well as the digital pens, digital tab pads are in much demand these days. Sanitizers and masks are also in demand, but this doesn't mean this is the real demand. This is the demand because we are shifting over to a new performer of working, and that's why it is required. Otherwise, this is not the real demand. Real demand was before lockdown. Whatever was the demand which was actually going up is the real demand. FMCG products are also taking the deal. Many companies like Hindustan Lever and Procter & Gamble and Cargill Foods. Cargill Foods manufactures the brand called Nature Fresh. Cargill Foods have reported that if such kind of FMCG demands are continuously being pushed by the customers, what will happen one day that our other production facilities will come to a still. That means if they have got a wheat division, atta selling division of wheat, and another product of that same company is like washing powder. Washing powder is the other product, and the first product is wheat, manufactured wheat, wheat flour. What will happen? There will be people working in wheat flour division, and there will be no people working in washing powder division. So these companies also don't want such kind of a graded demand. That is lopsided demand that is only focusing on one side. Important terms while we want to speak upon. Some few chats are coming. Just give me a second. Let me see. Ankita ji has got a question. I think I will be able to answer them as and when I'm going in forward. And Alok Mathur has also got a question. So as I move forward, I will be adding these questions in our. You can go through them. And I have actually inculcated all these answers into this itself. You can go through. GDP are the important terms since some students are there, just make them understand. GDP, employment, customer consumption, consumer economics, recession, work. These are the few very important terms which most of us have heard these days. I will just sharing a few details. This is the gross domestic product. It is the monetary value of all finished goods and services made within a country during a specific period. The calculation of country's GDP encompasses all private and public consumption, government outlays, investments, additions to private inventories, trade in construction cost, and the foreign balance of trade. Exports you have to add and imports you have to subtract. That way we get the correct value of GDP. The term used by government often late, the GDP is not working this because this is the reason private and public consumption has gone down. Government outlays are being shown, investments are done by government, no private investments are coming up, and private inventories are going down. Trade in construction cost is not there in private sector at all. Only government construction is going on, and that too the completion work of it. That no new construction cost is not coming up. Foreign trade has taken the beating. Foreign trade, you must be knowing, one very some small example while I was by visited Bareilly and all. Bareilly is called the rice bowl of, that area is called the rice bowl of India. They are producing a rice called basmati rice. Most of you must be known about it. The export of basmati rice has actually, this season seems to be like it must be like zero. Because of Middle East countries like Saudi Arabia, UAE, and in USA, basmati rice is in demand. These countries are not importing anything from India at present. and it doesn't show that they are going to import in the near future. Rice, you must be knowing that rice is being sown in this month of July, June, July, and monsoon starts and the rice is being started to get sown. Last year rice is the rice which is to be sold before August, so that when in September onwards the rice starts to come back to the go downs, the old market product is already not there. But this time it is the other way around. Their products are to be there, they cannot use them. So government has given an order that most of these rice will be converted through the process of fermentation and will be converted into alcohol, so that a lot of alcohol is available for sanitary purposes, like hand sanitizers and all, where alcohol is in great demand. And that's why government is able to control the prices of hand sanitizers. Otherwise, if you don't give the products in if you don't control the price of alcohol, how do you actually control the price of a hand sanitizer? So this is the government is going to control. So price value will actually used to enhance the production of alcohol. The other part of it is that once this production starts for alcohol, usually basmati is not to be considered in this case, but considering those low value rices has to be considered for this case. So they are actually, convert these low value rices into alcohol, what will actually happen is that there are a lot of chances that low value rices, those people who eat it or they are buying it, their prices will go up. So at present in the PDS system, when the government was recently giving rice and wheat free to the particular section of the society, the quality of rice was much more better than they actually got while they were buying it from the government a few months back. This was one of the reasons. So GDP should be considered in a whole scenario, except a few things. Most of the things have come to a standstill. Employment is the next employment is the next big thing which is happening. In our own company, I actually require 3 people from the IT sector, because Western Union is basically into money transfers, and we require people to handle our servers. The UP and Uttaranchal transactions, we have a lot of transactions too. But off late, due to people moving back from Middle East, from USA, from UK, we have biggest amount of transfers from Middle East, US, UK, Europe, and Australia off late. Around 20% business have increased from Australia also. But from Australia and New Zealand, the transfers are still happening. From UK, it is down. Europe, it's working fine. It's okay, not very good. US have come to a standstill. So our business has actually downsized to around 40%. I do require 3 persons to join under me, but company is asking for time. So employment I do have, but I can't provide people because of the pseudo demand which is actually creeping up. I want to increase the value of my product, but there are very few takers in the market today. And the term for this is called, usually used, is called in our marketplace, we use the kind of consumer confidence. It is very low. They are not confident if I actually transfer money to my parents or to my loved ones, and if I require the same money, will they be able to return me back to me? That is a problem. Loans have actually dropped down. So the unemployment or employment situation, if employment seems to be there, it is basically like pseudo-employment. And if unemployment is getting generated because of consumer confidence, getting low and low day by day. Employment is a relationship between two parties, usually based on a contract where work is paid. Lack of quality work in economy as of now, any reasons? Quality work just happens. Pseudo demand is the problem. Consumer consumption, consumer spending, consumption or consumer expenditure is on the lower side. Taking a lot of FMC, your monthly bills, if you might have been checking, are going up. Yet consumer confidence is down. So how could it be explained? If you actually go through the real data and all, you will find you are spending more into keeping things for the next month or for the whole of the month. Supposedly, if you're buying for only 15 days earlier, now you're buying the same products for 1 month, 30, 15 days, or like 45 days at a go. So your spending is more into consumption, which are fast moving consumer goods. Like soaps are getting sold a lot. Even not very big brand of soaps are also getting sold. But when it comes to hand sanitizers are getting sold a lot. Even yesterday or day before yesterday, I saw sodium hypochlorite getting sold at 200 rupees for 5 liters. I don't know what is the use of that product, but it was being sold in one of the stores. I asked the person, what is the use? Is it a phenyl or what? She told me, no, it is for sanitization purpose. And it is for not sanitizing human beings. People are using such kind of products, which are industrial products, which are not to be used in house. And I hadn't ever heard of people using this product ever. So people are using this also. So such kind of consumption has changed. The environment has changed. Professor Abhijit was just asking me that people are buying things like they are not buying this thing, they are not buying that thing. So this we called in economics as called substitution effect. If one of the products gets expensive, all of a sudden we start to buy something which is cheaper. And if supposedly just for example purposes, tomatoes at this period of time, the price of tomatoes have in the UP region in Lucknow, I think it's like 80 rupees per kilo, and 15 days back it was only 20, and 1 month back it was 10 rupees a kilo. Season is changing, it's raining, so because of weather conditions, transportation might have been the problem, or the plant may not be giving fruits at this period of time. Maybe I'm not very sure about, but the prices are going up. So whenever prices of a product goes up, people start to substitute it with other products. Whatever is the use of tomato, if it becomes very costly, people will start using tomato ketchup. If someone has produced tomato purees during the 10 rupee kilo regime, he may be able to sell it at high prices. 10 rupees tomato a kilo, maybe producing 1 liter of puree may be like 20 rupees. If the person requires to sell that particular product at 100 rupees a bottle, it will get sold today. That's for very sure, because tomato at 80 rupees will never produce a liter of puree. It will never produce. So they can sell it now. Like 20 is the investment. So these are the business opportunities which a person should know beforehand. If you don't know, that is because you don't know the environment of the country you are living. If you know these things, then it will automatically sell. The agrarian products require a lot of understanding. And once you understand the process of agrarian products, if you can package them and keep them for the like a few days, like 20 days, 30 days, you can sell them at a better price at the from the price you have actually bought them. Like you can't sell, there's a watermelon is a product. You can't hold the watermelon. Today, like 20 days ago, the price of a melon might have been 50 rupees. UP produces a lot of melon, so it may be 50. Yeah? It may be very costly at your place. I don't know much. So it is 50. Now the price of price of two melons is rupees 10. Because it's raining and melons don't stay in rains. So such kind of product is to be sold at lower prices because you cannot keep them. Mangoes at present in Lucknow started with 100 rupees a kilo. Now it is like 25 rupees a kilo because it's raining. It will not stay in the next 5 days. After 5 days, you will not have mangoes in Lucknow. You will not be able to have dasari in Lucknow. They will all get overripe and it will be tasteless from now onwards. So, best way of handling situations at this process is looking for agrarian products. For us, if you have a business, you have getting and converting them into processed food as soon as possible. Mangoes can be converted into processed food. The exact name in English, I don't know. They are converted into a liquid, and after that liquid, it can be stored through the process of making them into cakes. Mango cakes are available and they can be kept for a long period of time. Amchur is one of the other examples of keeping green mangoes. Green mangoes can be converted into amchurs. So these are the old processes which our grandmothers and grandparents used to process. And that was the reason in earlier days, such kind of demand cycles never used to happen so often. These days, demand cycles are very often happening. So substitution effect has been in pipeline, and anytime, whenever the value of money goes down, the substitution effect will always take care of it. Recently, HUL came a concern that some of the categories which can in-season demand, like sanitizers and all. So Dettol and Lifebuoy was flying off in stores, yet Dettol and Lifebuoy is available, but you will not find any sanitizers there. The only soaps and all things are available. But the availability is quite high, extremely high. So this is the substitution effect. People are not buying other things. We are investing into soaps and all. Recession, a period of temporary economic decline. And this is the process under which we are going at this period of time. Every activity is getting reduced. And the total business is, though not zero, but it is tending towards zero. A few businesses might have come to a halt. Small time players are not able to handle the situation. Big players are feeling the heat. One of the examples of this is, if you must be knowing, Future is the group run by Kishore Bayani. Future Group is feeling the heat at this point of time. They are in the process of selling their part to Amazon. Or Flipkart, which I think Amazon they are selling. They are sending it to Amazon to handle their businesses, and they will be like the extended arm of Amazon in brick and mortar. So this has been a very big group, and they might not have thought of these things like this. But when recession is in, then these groups are also trying to make the best out of it, whatever way. So anything to handle this particular term of recession, the best way is to actually develop a process of diversification. The more diverse you are, the more you are well-placed. Like many of you, those who are studying or those who have just gone through this process of studying and now they are doing something else. There have been I joined my MBA, I was, though it is not valid these days, this is not valid at all as per the Supreme Court orders and all. Just want to share a few things. We were made to be grilled under the process of ragging, and we were made to do whatever kind of activities we knew. Like I was asked to become a news anchor. I have been good in speaking throughout my school careers and all, but I had never used the method of being a news anchor. So one of my seniors was at the back of me, speak like a news anchor. So actually he taught me how to modulate my voice. It is not about being a news anchor. He was actually teaching me to modulate my voice. Though this is not of well worth today, but I'm speaking to you all, and maybe like I'm speaking to you all, and I can really feel thankful to my senior who made me talk on these topics around 18 years, 20 years back. So many of you must be having your hobbies, any kind of hobby. Suppose you are very comfortable talking on a video, like TikTok is banned now, very well talk. Many of you must be knowing why actually you people know or not. I'm not supposed to ask these questions, but yes, I would like to give my own part of it. TikTok was actually using your psychology. Most of us are not comfortable talking in front of others. Before TikTok, there was a very known popular term which we used to know about, called a bathroom singer. A singer who wants to sing, but he doesn't want to see the audience, or he doesn't want the audience appreciation, anything where he is exposed. He doesn't want to get exposed. Thus, such kind of singer is called a bathroom singer. TikTok usually handled the careers of those people who didn't want to get exposed in front of a lot of people. But when very intelligent people who joined TikTok, they saw that there are a number of people who have talent and do not want to show them, but they want to share it with others, but as followers, and so that they can take them out of their followings when and wherever required. So they started developing a lot of videos which were worthwhile, and they were getting paid for it. So this is one of the important things to understand. Your own talents can be a very good method of utilizing this time, as well as if it is possible, you can earn also. And I think most of your parents will not be unhappy with you if you start a channel on YouTube. If you are there in job and you have a lot of time, and yet you can think you can run a channel on YouTube, your parents will not be unhappy at all. Because if you are earning whichever way, name, fame or money, they will not be unhappy at all. At least that will be making you feel happy that you are alive and you are rocking. So anytime while you are going through all these phases, it's better to look inside you. Introspection is the best method. This is not happening, government is not helping, this is not happening, that is not happening. That is always will happen. India is not the most productive or the most developed country in the world, where government listens to you. Each and every one, the government cannot listen. So be productive in yourself and always focus what are your talents so that you can use the best of this recession. The other terms required in a particular trade is called man, machine, material. This is a part of costing. Whenever we are going through the methods of costing, when we are learning this thing, man, machine, material, we calculate. Man is affected by lack of work. If you don't have work, if unemployment is there, low demand is there, creeps in. So this is, if there is no work, unemployment will happen. If there is there is unemployment, then low demand will happen. Because if you don't have employment, why should I invest? And if I don't have employment, so why should there be work also? So until unless these are all into actually interwoven. You cannot break this chain until unless you push this demand. So demand is the ability to pay, and it can be generated by putting money in accounts or by giving in advance, as the government has just done. It is a loan. Government is giving loan to the private sector and different organizations. That is, they are putting advances in their spending, and they are not, it's a loan, but it's without any interest. 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs is a loan without any interest. That means they have to pay back the loan part of it. No interest is required. So this is the pushing part of the government to generate demand from the market. And when they are giving 2,000 rupees, 1,000 rupees, 500 rupees in the account of different varieties of people like auto rickshaws, people who are running auto rickshaws, people who are running rickshaws, people who are very weak in society, just to increase demand. Who will do that? If government, then the GDP has not generated enough of taxes from the system. Like government wants to give money to the people, and they have not generated enough taxes from the system. Who will do that? Industrialists require demand first, which is lacking except in a few sectors. Like if you want to say that we will be banning China, Chinese products and all, and you ask Indian industrialists to produce mobile phones. At present, I think around almost 99% are telling that we will not be able to produce such kind of products in the next future also. Because first of all, we don't have the technology as of now. Secondly, technology, if developed, is not tested. And thirdly, if we actually start producing, what will happen? It will be so costly because of the initial phases and all. The industrialists will not be able to actually, will be able to handle the situation. And government itself cannot take up mobile manufacturing units. Earlier, during 1970s till 1994 and 5, governments were investing a product called Priya scooters. You might have heard, many of your parents or fathers might have used that scooter, Priya scooter. Priya was manufactured by Maharashtra government. Konark TV was manufactured by this Odisha government. Uptron was manufactured by Uttar Pradesh government, and they were popular brands. By my father, I hadn't seen the license though. He used to come under license, and even my father told me there was a license for running a cycle on the roads of Lucknow. I hadn't seen it, but there was a number on my father's cycle. So that kind of system India has already gone through. So I just wanted to tell you that government, at present government, these governments are not socialistic governments at all. They are capitalistic governments. They will not invest money for the benefit of people. Because all these scooters, even Priya has a problem, Konark had a problem, Uptron had a problem. All these had government jobs. Those who are working were having government jobs. But what exactly happened was that the government was producing at a higher rate and was selling at a lower rate. There was a lot of losses, and later they have to sell these particular brands to other private organizations who were not able. Priya was actually, the model was bought over by Bajaj Scooters, and Uptron got shut down, and people lost their jobs, and Konark also had the same dealing. So except Priya, no other brands had a very good ending. So government is not interested in helping society. These governments operate. Well, it's not the present government. The current government scenarios are not in the process of producing their own products. They will be asking the private sector to put in the efforts. They will be provided with cheaper loans, tax-free areas and all. But government at present doesn't seem to be into this. This is a socialistic environment, what I'm talking about. But the government is not interested. Present governments are basically into capitalistic mode. The machine, just want to tell you about from the last slide, the man, machine and material we are talking about. Now, what is the during this lockdown, what happened? The first one is the machine were at status quo. They were not affected by a lockdown because there was not a war situation. There was no bombing, nothing. It was just shut down for a particular period of time. Maximum, they might have required a little bit of overhauling. Otherwise, machines were not disturbed at all. Material, raw material, is stagnant at production places, lack of timely transport. So sold at low prices at the origin. Export is extremely low for basmati rice in Iran. Saudi Arabia has banned exports as of now. Public transportation is, which you might have heard, Indian Railways is the biggest transporter of India. It is, it was running till today, that is 30th of June. From 1st July till August 12th, it will again shut down because of surge in operations. So, there's a question, just a second. Gautam ji is asking a question. I just want to answer him. COVID-19 has pushed in the cause for unemployment in India. It is not the only cause. It is not the only cause, but it has pushed in a lot of unemployment issues because the companies were already facing a lot of issues in their like our company were facing this kind of issue. Since January, we were not able to understand what was the problem like. But in February, we were able to understand there is something that it is not, it's quite fishy. A lot of people are dying here and there, but the news is not coming back to the country because we were not actually, we were not touching them at all. But of late, after March, we got touched, and that's why it has had some issues in India also. But the problem of unemployability is because of consumer confidence. The consumer demand has actually gone down, which I think will come up back by September. Most of us will get jobs by September. Most of us. Experience will be in more demand. Mostly experienced people are in demand, but in this condition, it will be more in demand because see, there are two things which are very much required. Once a person should be sincere and the person should be in the need of the job. Fresher can be lacking in both the fields. At times, they are not sincere. At times, they don't need a job. They want an engagement. Getting an engagement, doing a job is a different process. And teaching a fresher online is a very difficult process. You can't teach. So, and we can't even share, like even in our company, I have a proceeding where I have a particular thing where I can look into my official servers, but I can't share these data with my new employees. I just cannot. So in my company, if I take up someone, I have to be physically present in front of him or her, or that person should be physically present in my presence. He can use the things, but without my presence, it cannot. So it's a bit difficulty, but by September, I think everything will be almost next to normal. Things will be growing up. Transportation is a problem which is going to culminate a few times here and there. Costings of transportation, this is an auto fare rise, was actually reported from one of the news articles which I read. It was 15 rupees that person was spending going to Mira Road, and thereafter from that same place when he was coming back, he has to pay rupees 60. Just a sec. Now, one thing more I just want to share is work from home is a new norm. Experienced can work. How can a fresher do it? Fresher can use a laptop. Fresher can speak. Fresher can see. Fresher can do a lot of things. The only thing is, without getting exposed to the customer itself, to the market itself. Market is, though, is not a physical place. It's a, it can be a virtual place also. So a fresher can get a job only when he or she has got a perfect blend of his training programs. He has gone under the training programs. He should be enrolled, him or her, in programs which are running online, like webinars and all, and where he can learn and have the certificates, and if there is possible, can should take up project work. And I strictly tell everyone, every student should take up project work so that their minds are busy and they can learn a few things. At times, money do matters. Many of you must be going through your engineering and management programs through a loan and all. I understand money does matter, but this is not the right time to earn money. This is the right time to earn knowledge, to earn experience. Even 3 months of work experience from home can land you up in a very good job. In a very good job, I'm telling you. It's very easy. But if you say no today, then it can be no after in the month of September also. So you need to be absolutely ready for all these things. One chat is coming up, just a second. Gautam ji has said thank you. Thank you, Gautam ji. Pay cuts amount up to minimum 20%, what fresher can will get. This is the new norm, even not to say, I don't know we should be talking about this or not, but I, being a senior person, I'm telling you, I am also facing a pay cut. So nothing special about it. I talked to my team members. Some have got, some are third party team members in our group. So their pay cuts, they are not being able to, after pay cuts, they are not able to handle the situation in their homes and all. So they have, I am speaking to them, and see, what I feel that I am actually looking, they look into me as their godfathers here in UP and Uttaranchal. So I treat them as my kin and my own relatives. So I have seen to it that if anything is that, like, I can buy a lot of things and I can share with them. They actually take groceries and all, I am taking care of them. Money wise, I thought of, but later I thought that is there should be a work ethics. I can't give money to every of my employees, and I'm not that rich that I can give them day in day out. What I can provide is whosoever is asking me on phone, whatever is the problem, like, I buy those products for them. It is like a loan, which I tell them. If they pay back, well and fine. If they don't pay back, that is also well and fine. Just to make them understand, this is a part and parcel of their life. It is not my life. They have been doing this. Whatever they are getting the pay, it is because of their own doings, not for me. So just to make them understand, then if you are a learned person, if you are not getting a proper amount of money, because of some other reasons, then that person can be really helped. But a person who has actually thought of earning a low end salary, and all of a sudden he thinks of that his life should be running as it was earlier 3 months down the line, it is a difficult scenario. They have to understand. So this is one of the things we are doing at present. Future concerns are like what to do. So a few things I have made here, and you can go through. Let's first know our weaknesses. Let's do reverse engineering on our strengths. See, what I believe from my MBA days itself, that there are two kinds of things. One is called the strength, one is called the weakness. The strength is one thing which we are very confident of sharing. The weakness is one thing which we don't want to share at all. So anything we are creating, and we want that people should not be like, people should not know our weaknesses, will actually kill our trust on ourselves itself. Like I tell you a few weaknesses of mine, though that shouldn't have been shared on this platform. But being all of you, maybe a few of you, most of you are students, I think. So one of my weaknesses was during my MBA days. Before that, I never smoked. So during my MBA days, there were a group of students who had, and during my MBA, it was the first time I was staying in a hostel. So during my MBA days, when I was there, so they asked me, why don't you try a smoke and all? So initially I said, no, it's bad, it's that. Whatever my parents have told me, it's not bad, it's the same, that. Later I thought that, no, anyone who smokes is a very intelligent person. He is actually a man. Remaining are English people. And those who are very intelligent, they actually smoke. So I tried a few times because in one of my class presentations, I was not able to do well. So I was very perturbed on that day. So again, they were asked me, why don't you smoke today? I tried my smoke that day. And it continued till I think 8 years I smoked continuously. And I was very happy by smoking. End of the day, I learned one thing. And today I don't smoke. It is like 13 years I stopped smoking. One day one of my doctors, when I was changing my job from PZ to Western Union, there are two questions, just a minute. That is the same thing. Two chats, just a sec. Thank you for your comments. Once I was there in, I was changing my job from Pizza Hut to Western Union. The Western Union has got a protocol. For a medical checkup, total medical checkup. So I went there and in this Apollo hospital, so they were taking me for medical checkup. I used to have, after every 3 months, I used to have a cough and cold effect. So it was happening for the last 3-4 years. So I didn't know what was the cause and all. I thought it would be like simple cold, and I have a cold and cough problem since birth. So I thought that would be the problem. There was a doctor there. She asked me, her name is not coming to mind. She was Dr. Shah. She was a lady doctor. She asked me, do you know the cause of this? Your lungs are getting, every time getting choked every time. Do you know the cause? I don't know the cause. Inside your lungs, there are few patches that are coming up in the form of gray patches. I don't know what these gray patches are called. What are the gray patches? But don't worry. I just let you know a few things before you actually ask these questions. So she told me that these gray patches are basically because of your extreme smoking habits. Okay. And when all these things were happening, I told them every 3 months, 4 months, this happens. This is the cycle you are getting into. Secondly, she asked me, have you heard about a product called ventilator? And I don't know what is a ventilator. She told me a ventilator at that time around 2004-05, the cost of ventilator, she told me, was like 1 crore. It was an important product. I hadn't seen and I hadn't heard about product like this. She told me that is 1 crore. So she told me just one thing, that God has given you 2 crores free ventilators, which are in the form of your lungs. Does your job gives you that much of freedom, that much of money, that you can buy these ventilators again in your life? And these are portable ventilators. When you get a ventilator, you are not able to move anywhere. These are portable ventilators. And then I thought, oh, this is really very serious. So anytime you know what your weakness, talk about it. And I really appreciate the doctor. She made me understand the importance of my lungs. I hadn't seen my lungs, but I'm thankful to them today because I'm able to speak because of them only. Otherwise, my voice wouldn't have been, able to hear. Always be thankful to Mother Nature, thankful to your strengths, thankful to your weaknesses, thankful to your teachers, thankful to your colleagues, mother and father, God, everyone. At least be always thankful. Today, if you are able to see the sun today, be thankful. Because of these eyes, I am able to see the sun. Otherwise, a few days back, it was coming to be like a solar eclipse. Everyone was fearful what was going to happen and this and that. So every day when the sun is coming up, be thankful to it. Solar eclipse doesn't happen so often. So the first weakness we should be knowing. We are a service provider, but there is no demand. Actually, we are not creators of anything. Just a second. We are not creators of anything. Most of us, we are producers of agriculture produce in India. We do not process a lot of agricultural food. You will not find a lot of processed agriculture food which can be kept for a longer period of time. We are the largest manufacturer of spices in the world today even. It was prehistoric time, we were the largest manufacturer of spices even today. That means we are the specialist in manufacturing of spices. No one can take this away from us. Secondly, we provide services. Like we are into IT field, we are into engineering field, we are into education field. The maximum number of teachers in English are imported from India to China. And we are a better workforce than Chinese in the world. Most of you must be knowing it. So because of our ability with language of English, it is the only that we are low in production of basic products, such as like even a ventilator. Recently, a company was producing ventilator in my store, and government asked it to produce full-time ventilators for the country. And it was in the month of March, April. It was coming up in the newspapers. The company name I didn't actually able to find again. I have forgotten. So it was importing 60% parts from Europe. DRDO was asked to help the company. And probably the company is manufacturing today or not. It is not there in the newspaper again. So I'm not able to give you the exact figures for today. But they were in demand at that period of time. Then some Gujarat-oriented companies have dropped in and they have started producing the portable ventilators. They are not exactly at par as per government reports, but they are working it out. That means this is our weakness actually. We don't produce ventilators either. But our strength is that people are trying to do it. Reverse engineering to use them as strengths. China has developed itself because of this reverse engineering process. There are many products which China produces. Even a car they produce, but that doesn't sell in the world. They produce even aircrafts, but no aircraft is better than an American or a Russian aircraft. Even Indian produced LCA is being tested today. But they are much better than Chinese aircraft. So you can understand China do reverse engineering, but they cannot have the best knowledge available. They want a market to test that knowledge. And they are using India as a market to test that knowledge. So don't become a testers for Chinese products. Become a user for products, but don't become a testers. So, we should always supporting becoming a tester for an Indian product than for a Chinese product. So indirectly, if you want employment for yourself or your family members, you should be supporting Indian products first, so that once you test a product of Indian make, it may be anything, and that company starts producing more, there will be more employment generated. When they are more employment will get generated, obviously a lot of people will get work. If we test a product from China and there is more employment get generated, there will be only Chinese people who will get this work. We will not get the work. We will be only buying their products. So more or less, if we understand the importance of economics, first of all, you should be, Swadeshi is not the term. Local for local is not required. If you understand using an Indian product and testing an Indian product and verifying that product will help the company grow, to produce, to have confidence in building that product. There may be a few examples I will give you. You might have heard of a company called Raja Biscuits and Bisque Farm. These produce are basically from the eastern sector. They are from Calcutta area. So these biscuits are available in Lucknow also. If you want to have a alternative to Monaco or any other product of Parle or Britannia, the next produce is from India itself. Then the Chinese product doesn't come in. No Chinese food products are available. I hadn't seen any Chinese food products in India. Mostly they are Indian companies having a few technical helps from even a chow mein is not produced in China. It is produced in India. A chow mein of a Chinese brand is not available in India. But it is all produced in India. Even Cheng's is an Indian company. Name can be Chinese, but they are Indian company. So a lot of things are coming from Indian companies itself. In every field, we are not there. But in most fields, we are there. So please support Indian companies first and then look out for other companies. And you become a user of those company products, not a tester for these products. The next part is like we are in process of talking to, especially I work as a consultant to a few companies, startups in UP, and I work as basically as a elder brother to them. Every time chargeables are not possible from them, so I work as an elder brother to them. So they have got the idea that wheat and rice are under MSP, minimum support price from the government. Vegetables don't have any MSP. The farmer usually doesn't get a lot of money by selling the vegetable. It is the middleman who actually produces this, uses the stuff in between. And you might have just have given you a few examples about a bottle guard is sold by a farmer at 1 rupee a kilo. It's not a piece, it's a kilo. And we are buying in the city at 20 rupees a kilo. So you can see the margin, it's like 200%. So in this case, they have been able to, and the farmers are telling that we have got so much of bumper crop this time. There are a lot of vegetables available even in Lucknow today, because and it's already very hot and sweltery, yet there is a lot of vegetables available. So that means this season it is going very well. Yet they are saying that we are devastated because there is a bumper crop, but people are not ready to buy. Because you cannot buy 100 kilos of bottle guard and keep them in your home. You just can't actually store them. It's not potato. It's not onions. So these are the problems which a few chats are coming up. Thank you for your comments. The farmers are devastated because of this reason. They feel devastated. So most of you who are there as students and all, if you can develop some apps where these can help these farmers. And you might have seen during lockdown, there was a person, and I think, there was so much of news, everything I couldn't remember. That person was helping the farmer to sell their produce of watermelons from their farms, and that app was helping them to sell them as to sell in the wholesale market. That farmers were very happy, and I was very astonished to find a farmer also knows how to use a app and all these product methods because that person was helping. So if you want to actually stop using Chinese products, or you want to, actually it's not Chinese, it's actually getting more into for our local producer and all. More into it. You have to feel that other Indians are equal partners. If you always feel, no, I will earn, I will not give anything else to others, that's where you will be actually kicking your, as in English, it is kind of kicking your own ass. What has happened today is because of this only. We have not been able to help our own people. So be Indian, being Indian is only a lip service which we usually use. During 15th August and 26th January, we automatically become very patriotic. And throughout the year, we forget all these things. But throughout the year, you use all these things. Farm to fork was a term used by Reliance Fresh when they started. And they started in UP, were actually due to some hassles in political environment, they had to move away from UP. In UP, Farm and Reliance Fresh doesn't work. They don't sell vegetables. Otherwise, in other states, they might be, but in UP, they don't sell. So that has been the one of the very basic components, and I was very impressed by that concept. Actually, I was in the process of joining Reliance Fresh as a marketing head for UP Uttaranchal, but all of a sudden, the things started to happen the other way around, so I dropped the idea. So I was able to understand these processes very well then. Need of the hour is just streamlining process already and building upon it. Supposedly your parent is into, your father or mother are into producing something. And that can't be sold to other people because, or their market is not growing because the local market is already saturated. What's the way? There is Facebook, there is social media, and help your parents grow. You can be a marketing manager, you can be an engineering new ideas for your own parents, and later on it can be converted into a business. Because one thing I would like to tell, we are not producers, but we have a lot of businesses in India. Production is different, businesses are different. Businesses earn by selling a product already manufactured by someone and selling it to others. They are middlemen basically. Their earnings are from commission. And the commission part has actually gone up. The production is there, the customer is there. Only the middleman commissions are not coming, that's why he's not selling. So hoarding is one of the methods they use to actually increase the price of the product. But the company production usually doesn't increase. The price of the product usually doesn't increase from the company. It is because of the middleman that actually rises up. So this is the reason why we as a country are having a lot of billionaires and millionaires, but yet they are feeling that kind of feel because they don't produce. Because production is the only method out of getting employment. Middlemen don't employ a lot of people. They don't require a lot of people. Production does require. Transportation does require a lot of people. A lot of people is required in transportation, but a middleman exactly doesn't require a lot of people. They require a lot of labors actually, and labors are not, we are not in the category of labor. So it's not, we, there may be employment, but it will not really a very fruitful part of us. Now anyone in your chat boxes, if anyone can name this person, and name is given, what, why is so popular? This name is Khushpal Singh. This is the link. It is a particular news that has happened. His full name is Khushpal Singh. He is the owner of DLF. He is aged 90. He wanted to sell his DLF at rupees 26 lakhs. The next thing is that 1975, when most of us hadn't taken birth, a few of us, except a few. So we wanted to sell DLF. At that period of time, it was, he wanted to sell at rupees 26 lakhs. 26 lakhs at that period might have been like 2600 crores or something like that. But at this time, the value of the company is 40,000 crores. So why I'm adding up this part of it is it's I'm just last day when I'd like to add the importance of ethics. Just a second. The importance of ethics I just would like to add. Because most of us think that not most of businessmen which have problems, even many new startups when they have these problems, they think that by not paying workers, they actually get a way out of not giving them salaries and all. Just to give an example of this, that importance of ethics, I'm just giving you a few write-ups about this person called K.P. Singh. He has shown that you might have been, even I have been taught ethics, and most of you might have also gone through the importance of values and ethics. I've been taught in your courses, engineering and management courses, and all that are taught. He is the one of the few examples who have actually developed the total model on ethics itself. Very few models, I'm going to tell you. Tata is the next one. Then you have got Ratan Tata has got more goodwill value than his actual assets because of this, his importance of ethics. And then Birlas have got good amount of ethics. Mahindras are growing into it. Mahindras had not been into the best of ethics till date, but then now they are going into it. And a lot of companies are actually working on this today. Because once the top management doesn't follow these very small process of ethics, the lower management automatically stops delivering such kind of ethics to the market itself. It develop a very, like in Western, we just want to tell you, our ethical standards say that anything under 50,000 needs to be given in cash, anything above 50,000 to be given in checks. One of my clients in Amroha, what he did is that that was a lady who had a money transfer. It is around 10-12 years old story. She had a money transfer from Dubai. Her husband was in Dubai, and that person transferred 26,000. And Mr. one of our own clients, franchisee, logged in the. We have to like the process of questioning is very simple. We have to log one of the MTCN numbers, money transfer codes, and he logged that money transfer code in his account, and he got the transfer within 5 minutes. But he told the lady that I will be able to pay you after 7 days, whereas the company standard says that you have to pay the lady because it is under 50,000. Pay the lady then and there in cash, and you will get your interest or whatever commission after you pay within 3 days. And this they have already signed. And the other part was that anything which is above 50,000, you have to pay the person then and there in check. Every payment is then and there. There is nothing called 7 days or 6 days or 10 days of the loan. There is nothing called that. And that's why we have a franchisee. So he tried to bypass the system. And when we came here upon all these things, I went personally to the person. Earlier also he had done the same thing. I went there, it took me, Amroha from Lucknow is like, it's beyond Moradabad. So it took around, it's around 400 kilometers. It took around 2 days time for me to reach, actually getting a booking, done everything. I reached there, asked him, had you paid? So he, till that day he hadn't paid. I called up the lady, asked her to come. I made him pay that day. And I cleared a lot of things. Earlier payments also, I sat with them for 2 days, got everything cleared. And thereafter, once I came back to Lucknow, I saw to it that his franchisee got closed. He was one of the, he was actually the number three franchisee for us in UP. But he had done these kind of unethical things for more than 10 times in the total scale of 5-7 years. So it was my very tough decision for me because I didn't want to lose such a kind of a client for us. But we have to do it because of our ethics standards. And before closing, I had talked with a few more franchises so that we can share his data and his clients to them once they were in process of opening up, and he was actually in the process of closing down. So ethics are very important. Otherwise, what will happen? The trust of the person in our product. See, Western Union is a purely trust product. It's not a bank. Someone sends the money from a foreign nation, and it is reached it reaches in our account then and there. And the server of that foreign nation informs our server in the India context, and we open the transaction for anyone to purchase it. Whosoever purchases it, he or she in the near area of that person, where suppose the person requires the money and has sent the money in Moradabad area, the person can only buy it and purchase the things only in Moradabad only, not district Moradabad, city Moradabad. So he purchases it and he has to deliver the things then and there. So these are the ethics a company has to follow, because the customer is actually believing on us because of this reason only. Otherwise, there is nothing so special in Western Union today. There is nothing so special. It can be done by anyone else. Only thing is that we deliver the money through cash, through a remote area where they can take out, like Google Pay, you can Google Pay anyone. You can do Amazon Pay. But where will you get the cash? You will not get the cash anywhere. You have to encash it in your accounts. There you have to pay again. So there, encashing is absolutely free. So that is the reason we are still alive. So this is the goodwill and this is the USP of our product. Otherwise, this product is available everywhere. And the other part is that we can handle the maximum amount of 1.5 lakhs at one go, which other pays are not. In India, I'm not very sure about. From foreign nations, you cannot share such big amounts to India. It's not possible. So you have to take a license on this. So it is not possible in other pay systems. And if it is possible also, anytime, you cannot get it in cash then and there. So that is only possible in Western India. So this is the ethics part of it. The story has numerous turns and twists. He read in a small madrasa. You can understand, actually just want to give you a few basics of his background life so that you can understand that he's nothing from out of the blue. He's nothing. He's all like us, you and me only. No one could even have thought of a wild guess that he would script the world's most colorful business stories. Much wishes he wanted to get enrolled in military academy, Dehradun. But he quit his army and he joined here. His family, he got then into his family real estate business. Real estate was his father's father-in-law fledgingly company. He wanted to shut it down as it was almost bankrupt due to obstructive contractions. It was the same period company as a whole. He also has the same story like Dhirubhai Ambani. Dhirubhai Ambani was a very shrewd and a very intelligent man who actually spoke to the Prime Minister then, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. And DLF was like Mr. K.P. Singh was lucky. He spoke to Rajiv Gandhi. This is the story of how he met Rajiv Gandhi once. This is the same details. This is the last line which I would like to say. He met Rajiv Gandhi on a dusty road in Gurgaon. Once he went there to understand why people will not sell their lands to the DLF organization for building up buildings and all. So Rajiv Gandhi was also moving there. All of a sudden his vehicle got struck. So next thing what happened was, so K.P. Singh was talking to a farmer nearby, trying to persuade him to sell his land. He offered Rajiv Gandhi a charpai near a tree to rest as the engine cooled. That time, you might have known, in 1980s and 85, 70s, 85, and engine need to be cooled through water and all. So that was the reason. today Indians don't require such kind of conditions. So Rajiv Gandhi asked him what he was doing sitting in the field beside a well on such a hot day. Singh told him that he wanted to build the most modern city in India. And if you are well versed with Gurgaon, any of you or most of you, if possible, you will find more DLF buildings there than anywhere in India. The hub, the total development of DLF has been done by Gurgaon has been done by DLF itself. Most buildings are there, even business offices from everything, from Sushant Lok to DLF City, everything is there with DLF. Rajiv asked him to make a presentation to his mother, Indira Gandhi, and thereafter the proceedings started. Rajiv Gandhi might have been knowing about. Rajiv Gandhi has been one of the most, after 1988, there had been many companies which have dropped in India, like Toyota and DCM Toyota, you might have heard of. The Cantors which you run in Delhi regions and anywhere in India, the light trucks, they are from Toyota. And DCM is the company, Delhi Cloth Mill, which has actually got integrated as a joint venture. Toyota, while selling cars, was actually joint ventured with Kirloskar. And a lot of companies have joint ventured. And thereafter, they have been able to sell a lot of products in India. And mostly the products were from that period of time was from Japan. They were, Japanese, you, as you know, they are the, one of the best producers of mechanical and electrical goods in the world. So most of them actually were from Japan at that period of time, 1988 onwards. And Rajiv Gandhi has been one of the foremost persons who actually promoted opening up of markets and new deals and new collaborations to come. Even Maruti Suzuki was one of the pivot projects during Indira Gandhi time, and supported by Sanjay Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhi later on. There were no looking back after that. Singh, however, carefully ensured that the farmers selling their land were given a good deal and even helped them buy a larger piece of land in the areas of Alwar. Alwar is more dry area than Gurgaon, but it has been developed by making people getting good deals there. And it is because of this person called Singh. He also helped them restart the agriculture business. DLF has got 150 projects, developed 33 million square feet at a land bank area of around 13,000 square areas, and it's a large part of Gurgaon today. The story goes on for Singh, and this is the most important thing is, it was good deal for farmers because they could settle elsewhere and live a better life. He promised that he would pay them back whenever they wanted. This is the part of ethics that I would like to tell you. He kept his word, and every month on a designated day, Ajit would go into the villages, disbursing the interest on loans he had taken from the villagers. This built trust, helping him to get more land and also gathered the capital to start construction activities. Today, it has been a showcase for offices. Modern, resilient buildings are there. A lot of things are there in Gurgaon. Nothing, most of us must be knowing about them in Gurgaon today. So, DLF is like the, for me, it's one of the best examples for showing ethics to our new future students and future our entrepreneurs, our managers. So that whenever you enter a company, please be sure that you follow these principles, because these old men, like in he is 90 years old now, emeritus now. But I would like to tell you that they have shown the right way how a company can grow. Otherwise, in these fields also, you must be knowing that Chinese companies are coming to develop the properties today. There have been a company called Sahara India, real estate, they were into it. And they have to sell 5,000 crores worth land in Gurgaon for peanuts when they were engaged into non-ethic behavior. Then you might have heard about Nirav Modi. Nirav Modi's first creation sold at 18 lakhs. Could you imagine a person who was just making necklaces? He sold his first creation 18 lakhs, and thereafter he became rogue. Otherwise, I really appreciate the way Nirav Modi is a very good designer. But only lack of ethics have actually created this problem. And even Vijay Mallya, you must be knowing. I have experience with Kingfisher Airlines, and till date, it has been my best experience. I hadn't seen so beautifully maintained aircraft. Even Go Air is very good at present time being, but Kingfisher was a bit expensive than Go, and same routes, but Kingfisher was absolutely when you get in it, you feel as if that you are sitting in a Raja's chair. So that kind of environment he has created, and such a knowledgeable person. He's very learned person, but he has used his techniques in creating problems. And today you can see what has happened to Vijay Mallya. Whenever I look at him, I really feel very sorry. Such kind of intelligent person should have been actually been utilized for the nation's purpose, but he has utilized his energies at some very, because you might have known about this IPL cricket matches and all. One of the foremost Formula One IPL matches, Vijay Mallya has been one of the most foremost persons who has actually put in a lot of money on all these things. But see what he has actually done. So ethics is one of the very important things. Part of. Otherwise, if even at today, at 90 years of age, there is no criminal case against DLF owner and all. There must be some reasons. There must be some reasons against Tata's people to believe so much. Even for our prime minister, there must much belief in them from other people. So I really feel that ethics is one of the most important things. Even this in this pandemic situation, when you are even asking for a job, when you are doing a job, see to it that you don't do it sincerely. Forget about money every time. Don't calculate money every time. Join a job which has got sincere work. Join a job which has got a lot of potential. Join a job which talks about ethics, which talks about development, and accordingly work in it. Thank you. And any questions? I'm getting a few questions. Let me check out on the chat. Someone is sending. Okay. Attendance is there. Any questions? If it is there on chat. What benefits smoking in mentality, Pintu Jharmonia? There are no benefits in smoking, dear Pintu. There is no benefits. You will be losing your lungs, which is like, as I told you, 2 crores is equal to, now they not be that costly, ventilation not that costly, but then it is worth lakhs. And they are mobile ventilators. So it's better not to get into smoking and enjoy your life as you are having it now. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, at present I am through. Anything else?
Thank you. And I was producing a television. So, government brands. And previously, I was in the business of handicraft trading with the steel articles. And rightly being said by you that in the China, the government, what was doing was we were having a competition from that field, because at that time, our costing was 22 rupees more than the costing of the China. Mm. And when I inquired about the things, then I found that why they are selling it at a very low price, because the all the iron cost is being given by the government for all the products which are being exported. So that was the problem, and that's why we were losing all the tenders and everything at that time. So this is the policy part. Very rightly been said to you, said by you, sir, that it is the policy part which will decide all the things and the directions. And there was one question I was looking in that somebody was asking that what we should do. Even the opportunities which you are telling that Nagpur, we can go for aam papad making, we can sell. Our venture has been Alok Industries producing the PPE kit and all other materials at Alok Industries. So he has also explored this whole field.
Yes. I would like to share a small, if I could recall, earlier Pfizer used to actually produce mango pulp from Alfenzo mangoes, and they used to give it to their doctors, whosoever used to, as a free gift.
Yes, sir.
And Alfenzo, through they were a tinned product. They were actually from US. They were not from Indian. I just want to tell that there are a lot of things which can be done. Only thing is we are learning to become ready, but we are not ready at present.
Definitely, very truly said, sir. Opportunities are to be explored.
Absolutely.
And then we will get the things. Professor Khan. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Sir, you are audible, sir.
Yeah, I'm audible.
Yes, sir. Now I will request Professor Khan to officially end the ceremony by Chandranath, sir, forming with us.
For being such a nice session, such an informative session, and he accepting our invitation in one call and spare his valuable time and present very informative session and very nice terminology and with his own experience and with his own examples. So initially I think the terminology of the product is suitable for all types of audience, and very, very nicely he delivered and he covered all the aspects of the recent harnessing benefits after lockdown, and we need to explore the new avenue, we need to explore the new dimension that suit current environment and current environments of COVID-19, and he explained the business situation right now in 2020 that rightly said that can't move forward, can't move backward, and can't stay like this for long. So right, very truly said, sir, we are in this pandemic situation. Led like this type of situation, economic grossly hit it, and the business situation, GDP, and you discussed employment, consumer economics, recession periods, man, machine, and materials, and the one of the most important point was the work ethic. So I would like to thank to once again our esteemed speaker Chandranath Singhji, whose deliberation and whose very nicely explained all the terminology with the examples, and his expertise shared in a very nice manner. And even I am as a man of mathematics could understand all the terminologies and what to do now at this situation. And he said that in this situation we are alive and we are okay. We thank the Almighty God that in this situation we make productive on yourself, we focus on yourself. And he suggested many different personal ways and means and what to do and not to do, and supports the Indian products. And so he give very good examples and connect all the things with the current scenario. Very good. And reverse engineering as well. The app, you can, as an engineer, you can make an app that can develop by means to marketing teams. Important ethics, goodwill. And these all were, topics were nicely covered by our speaker, Chandranath Singhji, and definitely this will be valuable for us, not only for the economist, but as a common man, what to do, and it is the need of our, that topic is having a great importance as a pandemic situation, that everyone is in dilemma that what to do and what not to do, and how long the situation prevailed in the current scenario, that's really put a question mark, and schools and college and university are grossly hit it, and that have left us to turn. So Chandana Singh ji, really we need to develop and focus on the new avenue and new explore the new ways that how we convert, because currently we are chalk and we are converting and are chalk and
Chandana sir, very on the behalf of whole JIT fraternity and Department of Applied Sciences, I really thankful to you, and in future also we'll call you and take your services in our college, sir. Definitely your generosity and very nice and spare the valuable time across the nation. And last but not least, I thank to Engineer Pranav Mishra, who's really support us, and without his support, this proposal of webinar would not convert it into reality. And I would like to thank our Director General Engineer Amit Agarwal, sir, Campus Director K.K. Paliwal, for providing constant support us to organize this webinar. Thank you, sir. Thank you all. And may God bless us. Thank you, sir.